Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we are going to learn what is Spring Boot REST and what is the core functionality of Spring Data REST and how to use Spring Data REST in our Spring Boot project with example. The core functionality of Spring Data REST is to export resources for Spring Data repository. It means we no need to create controller or service layer. We just need to create only DAO layer and it will directly communicate with DB. And we'll also expose all the current REST endpoint for our service. So Spring Data REST is the best feature and a powerful tool that automates the creation of RESTful services. With Spring Data REST, we can say goodbye to controller and service. With Spring Data REST, even a simple entity class and a repository interface can effortlessly generate complex REST APIs. It is the regular architecture that we are following in our Spring Boot project. First, we send the request from client. We can say Postman or any other client that we are using. Then request will go to controller. After that, controller will pass to service layer, and then service will communicate with the DAO layer, and then it will communicate with DB. But if we are going to use Spring Data REST, then we will send request from our client, that is Postman, directly to DAO layer, and it will communicate with DB. So it will reduce the layers and also remove the boilerplate code, so no need to create any controller or service class. Because Spring Data REST build on the top of Spring Data repositories and analyze your application's entity and expose hypermedia driven HTTP resources for aggregate contained in the model. So today in this video we will learn the fundamental concept and usage of Spring Data REST, and we'll also learn how to efficiently manage the database options with Spring Data REST. So if we are going with the regular architecture, so in this architecture we also need to create controller classes and service classes and then DAO layer also, and after that it will communicate with DB to fetch the record or to insert for any persistence operation. One of the notable advantage of using this Spring Data JPA is automatically manage the CRUD operations like create, read, update and delete without writing any queries. If you want to fetch all the record by using JPA, so we just need to call find all method of JPA repository, so it will fetch all the record from database. And if you want to fetch only single record, then we can call find by ID, so it will fetch the record based on ID. Without writing any code, it will handle all the CRUD operation with the help of Spring Data JPA. But if you want to create the CRUD operation, then we need to create controller and services classes also. But if we are going with Spring Data REST, then we no need to create a controller or service layer. So we can just declare our entity class and DAO layer. So it will directly, client will directly communicate with the DAO layer and also it communicate with our DB. And it will also support pagination and sorting operation also. So here we no need to create controller or service classes. For example, we have multiple multiple classes, entities, department, project, company, etc. So we no need to create controller and service for each. We just need to declare entity and its DAO layer repository classes. So that's enough with the help of Spring Data REST. So with the help of Spring Data REST, we can minimize the boilerplate and controller layer code. So okay, let's start to create one project and see how to use Spring Data REST in our application. So here I will just go for start.spring.io. And here we just need to define the project name. So here I have selected Maven project type. Project type Maven, language Java, and Spring Boot version is 3.2.0, and here group is core example, or we can give core gain Java knowledge, and here we can give the artifact name is Spring Boot REST example. Spring Boot REST example. So here we need to add the dependencies. So here I am selecting the Java version 17. So just click on the add dependencies. So here I will select the web. And second I will go for Spring Data MySQL driver, because I will communicate with database is MySQL. So here I will go for Lumbo, so no need to use any setter getter, and also go for REST repository. So here I have added four dependencies: Spring Web, MySQL driver, Lumbo, and REST repositories. So let me generate this project. So here I have just extracted. So let me open this folder and just copy the path of the folder and go to IntelliJ. And here I will select new project and select open. So here let me open the structure of this project. Source main Java. So this is our main class, Spring Boot REST example application. If we want to create a REST API with the help of Spring Data REST, so let me create one entity class first. New package, and package name I can give entity. Inside entity I will just create employee class. So here I will just create the entity, and I have added few properties here inside our entity. So it's showing add maven dependency. So let me go to our pom.xml. So need to check if we have inserted Spring Data JPA dependency or not. So Spring Data JPA dependency is missing, so it's not able to import. So let me copy this, and we just need to add Spring Data JPA here. So let me go back to our employee entity class. So here we can see our all the libraries are imported successfully, and inside our employee there is four property: employee ID, employee name, age, salary, address. So here we can see five properties, and we are using @data annotation, so no need to write any setter getter here. And here if you want to use, we can use @allarg constructor and @noarg constructor annotations of Lumbo. Now after creating our entity class, the next thing we are gonna do to create a repository to access a employees data from the database. So we also need to add database related configuration inside here application.properties file. So here let me paste all the configuration that we require to communicate with the database. So here I have added data source URL, that is localhost 3306, and database schema name and username root and password is this, and this is a Hibernate dialect that I have added. So let me create one package for repository. So here I will go to new, click package repository, or we can give DAO layer. So inside repository I will just create new interface, that is employee repository. And here I will just extend JPA repository And here we need to define the entity class name employee and its primary key data type, that is loan. So let me check the primary key data type. So here we can see it's loan. So here we just need to define the loan inside our repository. So here we can see I have created one employee repository, that's extend JP repository class, and employee is entity type and loan is the data type for its primary key. So by default, Spring Boot data rest will create rest endpoint for our like get, post, get by ID, put and delete. These five rest endpoint it will create automatically. But how we can check this? So I will go to browser and here I will just type localhost 8080. Okay, let me start my application first. So go to project, or we can also implement Swagger in our project. So we can easily look all the REST endpoints through Swagger UI. Okay, let me add one dependency so we can go through the Swagger UI to watch all the endpoints. So let me go to our pom.xml file, and here we just need to add one more dependency to implement Swagger UI in our project. So here I have just pasted one dependency, that is Spring Dock OpenAPI Starter Web MVC UI dependency, and version is 2.02. So let me start my application. So click on here, run. So I think our application has started. So application has started at port number 8080. So let me go to browser. So after 8080, we can just enter swagger-ui-index.html. So through Swagger UI, we can see all the REST endpoints that is created by Spring Data REST without creating any controller or service layer. So this is get employee and post get by ID, put that we can use to update the employee, and delete we can use to delete the employee, and patch is to update the employee. So let me call this API get all employee. So try it out. So it's also supporting pagination and size and sorting also by default. So let me execute this. And here we are getting the response from our API, that is employees and name is this, age 21, salary this, and address is this. So we can also call API get by ID and we can get the response based on its employee ID. So here we have executed get all, so we are getting all the employees. So like this we can call all the API. So here we can see total elements are 6. So let me delete one employee, that is employee 22. So if we want to employ this employee, new employee edit, so we just need to pass this ID, that is 12. So its primary key ID value is 12. So let me delete this, and after that we will check the size again. Total elements it's showing 6 here. So let me close this and go to delete employee by ID. So here I will just pass the ID 12 and execute, and here we are getting response 200, and new employee edit it was deleted. So let me go back and call get all employee. So first we are getting 6 employee and now it should return 5. So let me execute and we'll check the response. So here we can see new employee added was deleted. So here it's showing total elements 5 and default size is 20. It's supporting So if you want to check the pagination and sorting, so we can go here. So by default it's showing all the records, 5 records. So here I will provide the value for page, page number 0, and size I want to show 2 employees only, single page. So here I have added size is 2. Now execute. So here we can check the response again. So here it's fetching only 2 records. One is Lucky and second is Abhishek. And here we can see the total elements are 5, but the size is 2 that we are getting. So total pages it's also showing 3, because 5 records we can show only on 3 pages are required. Like this we can also perform post operation. Like if you want to add another employee, so we can go here, click on the post employee and click try it out, and we can remove the ID from here, and we just need to provide the name. So we can provide deleted employee 6, and age we can provide 66, salary we can provide 666, address we can provide HOID. So let me execute this endpoint and we'll check it's working fine or not. So here we can see the response 201. We are getting the response status code, and inside response body we are getting deleted employee 6 we have added. So let me call the API get all employee. So here if I will go here and execute, so let me check the response, but here we have defined the size, so let me remove this, or we can define 20 and execute it. So here we can see we have added deleted employee 6. So here we can check Sumit Pal 3rd, Bharat Chandrakant. So here we can see deleted employee 6 was added. So here we can see the list. So now we can see total elements are 6 and total pages are 1 because size is 20. So if you will fetch the 21 records, after that it will show the total pages 2. So like this we can create CRUD operation for employee or any other entity or repository class. And by default it has generated its path URL. So if we want to change its path, so we need to go back to our repository layer. So instead of employee we want to show something different. So what we can do, let me go to our employee repository, and here I need to use one annotation, at the rate resource. At the rate repository, resource, and here we need to define the path. So here we can define like customer, and we can save it. So let me stop our application and run it again. So here we can see here we are getting the path URL is slash employees, but now we have changed its slash URL slash path. So if I will run this application again and we'll check back, so here we can see our application has started port number 8080 and we have changed the path of our API URL. So let me go back to browser and refresh it. So now here we can see here we are getting the path URL is different, that is get customer, create customer, get customer by ID, put customer, and delete customer. So like this we can change the URL path of our APIs. And if you want to create REST API for our query methods, then we just need to go here in our repository layer, and here I will just define one method, list of employee, and here we just need to define the method name like find by name, and here we just need to pass. So here we just need to define annotation, that is @ param, and here we can define first name, that is a name, property name, and string name, and here we just need to import this class java.util package. So here I have imported. So here we can see there is only 6 REST endpoint for employee entity controller, customer, get, post, get by ID, put, delete, patch, but there is no search operation. So for profile controller there is 2 REST endpoint, but nothing more in this list. So let me stop our application and run it again. After that we can see there will be one more REST endpoint will be added in the list. So let me stop it and start it again. So this name is the field name of our entity class. So here if I will go inside our employee entity, so here we can see our field name is name that we have defined here inside our repository. So find by name is the field name of our entity class. So here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. So let me go to browser and refresh our Swagger UI. So it's refreshed. So let me check. So here we can see 6 REST endpoints, and here we can see one more employee search controller was added, and it is the new URL, customer search find by name. So here we can just try and execute it. So in the response we can see employee name Abhishek, age 21, salary this, and address is this. So we are able to get the record from DB with the help of Search API. So in this video, we have explored the revolutionary simplicity offered by Spring Data REST while creating RESTful API by eliminating the need for traditional controller and service layer. Spring Data REST automates the API creation process and allowing developer to focus only on business logic rather than its boilerplate code. So here we no need to use any controller or service layer. So we can directly communicate with our DAO layer and create the REST endpoints. Okay, thanks for watching this video.